my name is Francine. Welcome to my studio. I thought I'd take a moment just to introduce myself quickly. I live in the Philadelphia area of Pennsylvania with my husband and my daughter and a dog named Sunshine, who sometimes you will hear barking in the background. And I have enjoyed gel plate printing for quite a while now, and I thought I would share some of my process with you. I've done many reels on Instagram, and people have been asking for more of a step-by-step process, and I thought I'd share it, and let's get started. I have a 5x7 gel plate here. I have some paints. I have some pinks and purples. I have some greens. I do have a little bit of blue. I will show you these as I use them, but just so you know, they're there. And the reason I chose these colors is I tend to use the color wheel a lot. It helps me determine what color to go to next. So using this red violet family across from it is the yellow green. So that's why I thought these colors would be fun mix. And also we are doing a pear project, and this color's awesome for pears. So, all right, let's give it a shot. So I tend to start with a colored background. I don't like to have just white. So I'm going to start with just a little bit of yellow, because the greens going over top of the yellow will make them pop. If you don't know, green and blue, or excuse me, yellow and blue make green. Okay. So I have some 5.5 by 7.5 sheets of paper. Put that down. You really want to press down into the plate. This should come up pretty quickly and easily because we don't have much paint on our paper so far. So there's a little bit of yellow in the background. Okay. So I also have here some hand-cut stencils, something really easy you could try to do at home with either a heavier duty paper, or these are stencil blanks, or you could get a plastic file folder. And I just made some wavy lines, and we're going to try them in different lengths on our plate to make a varied background. So let's put a little bit of green on here. I have this olive, light olive green from Liquid Basics. Gonna put a little hint of that. You don't need much paint on this small plate. I do also keep this notepad close by just to roll off any extra paint. I use these papers then later for other collage. I have some really neat painted pages in here. You can also print on them. So I'm just going to do a couple funky lines here. Just going to start with some big wide strips first. So the parts that aren't marked are going to be parts that come off, or blocked out rather. And again, push down real good. Try to get around the lines of the stencil. See how that looks. Right, so we have a couple lines. Take these off. And sometimes when you take these off, they'll leave a little bit of a ghost print. I'm just going to leave that ghost print on there. It might help our varied background. This has a little bit of paint on the stencils that came off onto the paper, but it's fine. All right, so another color. This is called Fuzzy Caterpillar from Mondo Llama. I've been getting a lot of paints at Target lately. They're cheap, but they're fun colors, and they don't have a lot of pigment in them when you actually use them, but for this process they're kind of nice because you want something that's not super heavy, and when you're trying to layer colors it's kind of fun to see the other colors come through. And again, you don't need a lot of paint. roll that in. And I'm going to use different strips than I used last time, just to vary it up a little bit. And I'm going to do it a little different spots. Right, and then sometimes I use my fingers down in the corners just to line it up with the plate. It's not really important, but because we're doing a vertical stripe, we don't want it obviously sitting off to the side. It'll look a little weird. Okay. So now you see we're getting some varied colors in there. I kind of want to do maybe a light yellow on top of this. A couple of stripes in the light yellow, because that yellow is coming through there. It looks pretty. So now, because I have all this down though, and that yellow is not super opaque, it's more translucent, I'm going to have to add a little white probably to the yellow. Okay, so I am going to just mix two colors on the plate. So again, you don't need a lot. A little touch of that. A little touch of this. And get our brayer out. Maybe this, and then I tend to just kind of swish it around. If you go like this, it'll blend it right on there. Because I want the colors to kind of go here and here, I'm going to sit this under the plate so I can put those spaces where I know the color is going to come up right near that. Just trying to vary this a little bit. Okay, so that looks pretty cool. I'm happy with that, the way that turned out. And now I'm going to take you to the next step. I'm going to clean this plate off too first before I do that. I always just keep a little bottle of water sitting here, and I just squirt it with some water and wipe it off with a paper towel. You can recondition plates if they start to get too tacky. It's good to put a little bit of mineral oil on them and wipe it in quite a bit, and then just put your pieces of paper back on it and put it back in that clamshell it came in. So earlier, before I have done this video many times already, because this is my first one, and we make mistakes. I drew out this pear. I've put this up on my Pinterest. I'll put a link down below. But then what I want you to do is just cut this out, the silhouette, and then I get something like this. And I'm going to use this. I did use it quite a few times already. So, but it'll look very similar. You can even cut that leaf off if you don't want the leaf. I like it with the leaf on there. And in fact, after I put this up, when I went to go print it out, a million other silhouettes of pears came up. So obviously you could use whatever, but you have my permission to use this one. I don't care. And we're going to do this next step. Okay. So I did make another one earlier in this tone. I didn't really like it, so I put it aside. But we're going to now do the purple color down, and we're going to put the imprint of this pear on there. So let's give that a shot. So this is a pinky purple. Center that on there. Just give it a little tap. It's sticking up, but once you put the piece of paper down on top, it'll be fine. All right, so let's try this out, see how it looks. I'm gonna line it up again, my fingers. And now, because we have so much paint on the paper, it just might take a little bit longer for all that purple paint to adhere. You can always just poke up a corner while holding it still. It looks like it's coming all up. All right, let's see how that turned out. Oh, that looks pretty cool. I like it. And then I tend to just go in and outline it, maybe add a little embellishments here and there with doodles. But the pear turned out pretty cool. We'll do a couple more, or one more at least, because I have that other piece of paper here. I want to see if this made an impression. It didn't really leave a ghost print behind. So I am going to clean off the plate real quick. And now I have this one here. I might try this. I don't know how well that's going to show up. I have these other folk art paints here. They're pretty opaque when I use them, so I'm going to give this a try. This is called Ocean View, and it's folk art. It's their matte color. And we'll try to do this one real quick. That's probably too much paint. But you can see how much more opaque this color is. It has more pigment in it, and it's a heavier paint. Oh, that's starting to look really cool in there. I sometimes get addicted to these pages afterwards. And again, that would be an awesome pear as well. I'd have to do that. All right, so we'll put this down again. And I'm gonna take this guy and pop him down. And a lot of things is just really experimenting with your colors. I have a Pinterest board where I have saved color combos. The only thing you struggle with having color combos that you want is, again, sometimes they mix. Like this turned out not nearly like that purple that I put down, but more of a brownish color. But I still like it. And some of the other colors come through. Let's see how this looks. Oh, I like this one a lot. Sometimes mistakes turn out pretty awesome. That one really looks cool. And again, you could go in and doodle away on that if you wanted to. I have gold pens I put around the sides. Sometimes I do gold foil. Okay, so we have two of them that we finished today. And then I do have a stack of ones that I did play around with earlier this week. I did this one, and I did put a lot of pen work in there. And this was a Prussian blue. I used a lot of these pinks and purples in there. And then I embellish with the bright green. That's where I got my limey green in there. This was another one. This was a ghost print that pulled up. And then I put the green around it. This was a different stencil I used. And then this guy too. So there's a lot of various ways you could go about this. But try to have fun with it. Thanks for stopping in.